should I do when I get bored? I'm getting conflicting reports of like weather and traffic, but it's like we have a break in the clouds here, a little bit of sunshine, and I'm gonna go ahead and try to make it up this mountain. Chains, but everywhere else is sitting on chains, and I've never gone through here, so I've been on chains. Put these overalls on first so I don't ruin my clothes getting down in the muck. I'm not sure I'm done yet. Almost a full hour. We've been trying to get a hold of them for like 4 hours because we knew it was going to be late and we couldn't get a hold of anybody. But I'll find somewhere to park and let the Chiefs know. It happens. It's winter. Let's go.
Okay, closest spot? Probably 79.
South?
South.
What kind of spot is it? It's big enough. You know, I don't park at Walmart's because they can just decide they don't want you there and boot your truck and shit. Okay. And it's still south here too?
Yep.
Okay. Peace out, buddy. You too.
Reschedule. I could tell that guy was full on expecting me to be an ass, because when I wasn't, his face lit up a little bit and he started telling me places I could go, and like, I'm sure he's dealt with it plenty of times where drivers find out that they can't get unloaded and they'll throw a fit. It's like, well, I knew I was late coming in here. You know, it wasn't nothing I could control. It was about safety, trying not to get caught up in that mess that was up there this morning. It was all blocked up this morning when I looked at the weather app. They had like a 2 hour wait, and I just sat at the truck stop and waited. And then there was a break in the weather and they cleared the crash and it said it was free, and then I went through it. And it just took so long to get through there that I couldn't make it here on time. Last night was even worse. Like, the winds were really high and they weren't keeping up with it. So I made the best decision I could. I got through there safely and I got here as soon as I could. And they can't take it. That's just trucking sometimes. You know, the weather and the schedules don't always agree. But I could just tell he was like relieved that I didn't blow my top at him. And maybe not. Maybe he's just a friendly guy. But his face changed when I was like, all right, man. You know, he went from like trying to show like that he's sorry to being like, oh, you're cool. You know what I mean? Ooh. Now just hope I can find somewhere to park. Windy, but I found a spot. I'll just figure out when they're gonna take me, so hopefully tomorrow. But it really doesn't matter because the next load doesn't deadline until like Friday night or Saturday morning. So as long as they get me done before like Thursday night, I'll be good.
buddy.
As much as I would like to get the editing done on this video, I can't do it here. I have no service. I mean, I do have service. That's the thing. It shows like full bars, but 4G LTE, which usually works great. But today, it won't do anything. Can't watch YouTube. Can't watch Netflix. Can't edit my video. Because all the music and stuff and a bunch of the tools, like, it's online. Like, I have to have internet to edit. Almost a full 2 days later. Before I can get an appointment to deliver. Again, you know, hour and a half late. They made me sit for 2 days. Not they, my company, they the shipper, the receiver. How many pallets, by the way?
I sat here for 45 minutes waiting on my lumber phone call, or text, whatever. I finally get the thing, I'm trying to get it paid so I can get my bills and go, and halfway getting through, getting paid, I don't even know how to get around this building. Go to the other side, she said. So, again, after waiting for 2 days because of a snowstorm, I was a little bit late. I'm sitting here waiting to get my message to get my lumber fee paid. I finally get the thing. I'm halfway through getting it done, and I get a call saying, we're closing on this side. You have to go around to the other end and park and go into 345 and... they'll have your bills done there when you're paid. I'm like, okay, so you can't wait 30 more seconds to hand me my bills while I get this paid. I haven't really decided yet. I go down US 12. There's a mountain pass that I could or may not have to chain up on when I get there. Or I can add 50 miles to my trip and go down through Portland. I'll think about it. I have a couple miles to think about it. I'll either turn off on US 12 and go that route, or stay on the interstate, go down to Portland and go that route. I'm not sure which one I'm gonna do yet.
tree down or something. Some trees down that they can't get to right away. They wouldn't give an ETA and when we'll be rolling again. There's no cell service. I don't even know, is there radio service? You guys learn anything?
Not much, but it sounds like there's like six down trees.
Yeah.
And they got most of them bucked up and cleared off kind of by the runaway ramp.
Yeah.
Towards the summit.
Fun.
But yeah, I don't know. They were like, yeah, it's just high winds.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't worry about.
Fun stuff.
What's up, puppy dog?
He's getting tired of sitting here too.
Oh, I bet. Is it boxer mix?
He's just as far as we know, he has a blue heeler and a German Shepherd.
Oh, cool.
Other than that, we have no idea.
But we've got a German Shepherd with us.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
May or may not be in the car.
Yeah.
How far are you headed to?
I'm picking up in Wallula, going out to Wisconsin.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So I get to follow the storm all the way out to the Midwest.
It sucks.
Yep.
Damn it.
Yeah, it's going to be like minus 35 wind chills out that way.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Terrible.
Fun stuff.
Yeah. All right, man.
All right.
Catch you later.
Take it easy, bud. You can hear the trees breaking. Massive avalanche. They're closing it. Thank you. don't know just what I'm gonna do yet. I had to go in there and grab some stuff, but my head's been killing me. I you know, come up with all the excuses. I just am not in the mood for it after all that bullshit. And I don't have to be in Wallula. Deadline's in like 2 days. I don't know. I'm gonna eat my sub I just bought. Sit for a few minutes and maybe I'll take an 8 and then run down there and get this trailer turned in. I just don't feel like messing with it tonight. After all that crap. Another thing that sucks about West Coast driving is that it's 2 hours earlier here than it is at home. So it's only midnight here, which, you know, on a day like tonight, where I'm just kind of a shit night, I could have still called the wife and chatted with her for a minute. You know, she wouldn't have been happy about a midnight call, but it wouldn't be unreasonable. But it's 2:30 in the morning there, so. Can't talk to nobody. I need to make some more trucker friends that I can call and bitch about things with when I'm having a day like today. I'm having a week like this week.